Welcome to the video. Today we will discuss about the quantities and base units used in the electrical and electronic fields. At the end of this video, you will be able to know about the base units, usage of scientific and engineering notation, then how to convert from one unit with a metric prefix to another, and how to express measured data with the proper number of significant digit. So before going to the topics, let us know about the physical quantity and units. A quantity that can be measured is called as physical quantities. For example, length, mass, time, weight, etc. All the physical quantities has a numerical value which we call as magnitude and a unit. Now units are a standard used for expressing and comparing measurements. All the physical quantities are specified in terms of units which are standard values. Today all engineering works use the international system of units, that is the SI units. Now let us consider some examples of the physical quantity. In the first example, 25 kg, here the 25 represents the magnitude and the kg kilogram represents the unit. In the next example, 250 meter, 250 represents the magnitude and m, which is meter, represents the unit. Physical quantities are divided into two groups, the fundamental quantities or the derived quantities. The quantities which do not depend on any other quantities or the quantities which can be measured by an instrument is called as the fundamental quantities or the base quantities. There are seven fundamental quantities. The quantities which depend on fundamental quantities, or we can say which can be measured both by the instrument and a combination of the base units, are called as derived quantities. For example, to get the mass, we need a weighing scale to get it. For height, we need a measuring tool. These are the fundamental units, while speed, force, etc. are the derived units. Seven base units are mentioned here. The quantities are the length, mass, time, electric current, temperature, luminous intensity, and the amount of substance. The corresponding unit and symbols are given here. In the past, the English and metric were used for the system of units. The English system was based on a single standard, and the metric was subdivided into two standards, the MKS system and the CGS system. In MKS system, meters, kilogram and seconds were used, and in CGS system, centimeter, grams and seconds were used. But the use of more than one system of units in a world caused unnecessary complications to the basic understanding of any technical data. Therefore, a standard set of units was accepted by all the nations, and it is known as International System of Units. Power of 10 is stated as an exponent of the base 10 in each case. Here 10 raised to x, where 10 is the base and x will be the exponent. For a positive power of 10, move the decimal point to the right to get the corresponding decimal number. And in case of a negative power of 10, move the decimal point to the left to get the corresponding decimal number. In the electrical and electronic areas, we will come across both very minor and very large quantities. Scientific notation is a suitable method for expressing large and small numbers. In scientific notation, the quantity will be expressed as a product of a number between 1 and 10 and a power of 10. The number will have one digit to the left of the decimal point. Engineering notation is similar to the scientific notation. It is commonly used in technical field to express large and small quantities. In engineering notation, a number can have from 1 to 3 digit to the left of the decimal point, and the power of 10 exponent must be a multiple of 3. Let us consider an example for the number 44,000. In scientific notation, it will be represented as 4.4 into 10 raised to 4, where 4.4 is the number between 1 and 10, and it is having only one digit to the left of the decimal point and the power of 10. In engineering notation, the same number will be represented as 44 into 10 raised to 3. The number can have 1 to 3 digit to the left of the decimal point, and the power of 10 exponent must be a multiple of 3. Now let us consider the next number, 0.038. In scientific notation, the number will be represented as 3.8 into 10 raised to minus 2. Where 3.8 is a number between 1 and 10, and it is having only one digit to the left of the decimal point. In engineering notation, the same number will be represented as 38 into 10 raised to minus 3, where 38 is having two digit, and the 10 raised to minus 3 means the exponent is a multiple of 3. Units and metric prefix. In electronics, we must deal with computable quantities. For example, we must be able to express how much volt are measured or how much current are there, etc. So let us learn about the units and symbols for most of the electrical quantities. Letter symbols are used to represent both quantities and their units. One symbol is used to represent the name of the quantity, and the other symbol is used to represent the unit of the measurement of that quantity. Here in the table, it is showing some electrical quantity and their corresponding units with the symbols. Let us consider some examples. For frequency, the symbol is F and the unit is Hertz, and the symbol of the unit is HZ. Similarly, for energy, the symbol is W and the unit will be Joule, and the symbol of the unit is J. For voltage, we will be using both the symbol as V and the unit is volt. So metric prefix are used in combination with engineering notation as a shorthand for certain powers of 10 that are commonly used in electrical and electronic works. Some of the metric prefix and their symbols are shown here. For 10 raised to 3, it is kilo and the symbol is small k. For 10 raised to minus 3, it's milli and the symbol is M. Similarly, many are given here. Metric unit conversion. Sometimes we need to convert a quantity from one unit with a metric prefix to another, such as from milliampere to microampere. For this conversion, we need to move the decimal point in the number an appropriate number of places to the left or right depending on the particular conversion. For this, we have some rules. When converting from a larger unit to a smaller unit, move the decimal point to the right. When converting from a smaller unit to a larger unit, we will be moving the decimal point to the left. For this, we have to fix the number of places to move the decimal point by finding the difference in the powers of 10 of the unit be converted. Consider the problem to convert 0.15 milliampere to microampere. In this problem, milliampere is 10 raised to minus 3 and microampere is 10 raised to minus 6. So, we can write 0.15 into 10 raised to minus 3 ampere for milliampere. So, in this case, we have to move the decimal point 3 places to the right. So, we will be getting as 150 into 10 raised to minus 6 ampere. 10 raised to minus 6 is micro. So, we can write it as 150 microampere. Now, let us consider the second problem. Convert 2500 microvolt to millivolt. In this case, we have to move the decimal point 3 places to the left. So, we can write it as 2500 into 10 raised to minus 6 volt. So, after moving the decimal point, we can write it as 2.5 into 10 raised to minus 3 volt, where 10 raised to minus 3 is the milli. So, we can write as 2.5 millivolt. measured numbers. There will be uncertainty in the result whenever a quantity is measured due to restrictions of the instruments used. When a measured quantity contains approximate numbers, the digit known to be correct are called significant digits. Error, accuracy, and precision. What is error? The difference between the true or best accepted value of some quantity and the measured value is called as error. Accuracy defines how close a measured value to the standard value. Precision measures how closely two or more measurements agree with each other. What are significant digits? The digits in a measured number that are known to be corrected are known as significant digits. Let us explain the rules. The first one, if there is no zeros in the number, then it is considered to be significant. The second rule, if zeros comes before the number, then it is not considered as significant. If the zeros comes between the non-zero digits, it is always considered as significant. If zeros comes at the end of the number and to the right of the decimal point, then it is said to be significant. If zeros comes at the end of the number and without a decimal point, it is considered or not considered depending upon the measurement. Next is the round off, the process of dropping one or more digits to the right of the last significant digit in a number is called as round off. Here also we have some rules. The rules for rounding off are, that is, if the most significant digit dropped is greater than 5, we will be increasing a 1 to the retained digit. If the digit dropped is less than 5, there is no change to the last retained digit. If the digit dropped is 5, increase the last retained number if it is an even number, or otherwise do not change. This is called as the round even rule. So from the example, we can see that 10.071 is round off to 10.1. That is, this 7 is greater than 5, so 1 is added to the 0. In the second example also, 29.961 is round off to 30.0. Thank you for watching the video. For more details, you can visit our website or mail to us. Thank you.